Texas. Well, Dortmund is now just as famous for its leaky roof and water features as its huge stand behind the goal, which is tonight full of Dutch supporters. Netherlands bring in Daniel Marlin for Steven Bergwijn. May look like a back four on paper, but Denzel Dumfries will push on down that right-hand side and they'll swing round into a three at times. His crosses into the box usually are out to pick out Cody Gakpo of Liverpool. But the plan B will be the arrival in the second half, if needed, of Van Veghorst. England retained the back three that gave them better fluency in the first half on Saturday. The changes mark Gainey, back for Ezri Konsa, who has every right to feel a little hard done by. He was excellent. Kai Osaka, super on Saturday, will be the wing-back that does most of the attacking, with Trippier looking out for Dumfries. Bellingham never got to say goodbye to Borussia Dortmund. He was injured for their last game. His team lost the title that day without him, so a chance to leave his mark in this city again will be on his mind. Well, sometimes in defining moments, the most fitting words come from the ones who say very little. Bukayo Saka said that this England team are hopefully two games away from changing all of our lives and making some history. Let's go. We've gone top front today. Ali McCoist and Lee Dixon are here. Lee, Ali, what's the first few minutes got in store?
Well, we know what we're getting from the crowd already. It's an electric atmosphere. Both teams on an upward shift as far as performances are concerned, but it doesn't really matter. It's the semi-final. Just get yourselves over the line.
I just hope it's not cagey, Sam. I really hope both teams go for it, go try and win the game. Both teams, I think, to be brutally honest, have underperformed in the tournament. There's only Spain out of the top teams I've looked anything like the side we know they can. So I hope both teams go for it and we'll get a great match.
Well, the Dutch qualified as one of the four best third-placed teams. They played France without Mbappe, Poland without Robert Lewandowski, and they just scraped their way through the group. England too have improved incrementally. Maybe the Dutch will feel that they've done so at a slightly faster pace. And this may be a problem on that right-hand side with Daniel Marlin, who's just strayed a little bit early and it's offside.
Well, that'll give Trippier something to think about. Nice little run towards the ball and then a spin in the hole. He just went a little bit too early. You look on that freeze frame, it's actually probably just onside, but that's a little marker for him. And that's, I always like that as a fullback. You get a little marker as you know what the winger's going to do. So you kind of just lighten yourself up a little bit.
Absolutely, I get it, Lee, but if you're the Dutch, clearly you look at England with three centre-backs, you would think straight away that the space will be down the side of the wider centre-backs, and that's exactly what it's trying there.
Head of Gakpo just about after miscontrolling the initial pass, but England have got it with Bellingham. Showed too much of it to Simons. Rice. And the Dutch manager had to put up with a little bit of disruption yesterday. He didn't get the scheduled press conference with him, the player, because the Netherlands were stranded on a train platform awaiting the arrival of their transport to Dortmund. In the end, had to take a plane, a hastily rearranged flight. Got here late last evening. He shrugged it off and said no damage done. As Gareth Southgate said, they'll be okay, they'll still get dinner. And they did. A slip from Phil Foden. Just another example of the pitch cutting up as he was found by Jordi Schout.
Played out it well though, got to say, they looked for a tight high press from England, but they played out it well.
Marlon wanted it played early from Simons. chance. It almost came through to him, but I think that was Carl Walker, and across was Mark Gahey.
It just shows you the danger, Sam Lee. It just shows you the danger. If you go for the high press and you don't close them down, it's relatively easy to play through you. And the Dutch did it well there. Just a little bit of a warning for England.
Yeah, that was Trippier. Everybody was on point then. He was just 2 yards too late. And that just enabled the left-back position to open up for the Dutch.
Bit of room for Bellingham. And now for Harry Kane. Saka peels away. Ake goes against him. He's being backed up by Walker here. And Saka chooses the far post. And flicks it away. Trippier will retrieve it. Spaces in between the lines is going to be important tonight. It's a bit early from Trippier and an offside flag is up.
It's a silly offside that. I mean, I don't think there's any excuse for that at all. You just look across the line. It's 2 yards offside. Look across the line, stay onside, keep yourself in the game.
Well, England may be yet to provide the nation with a sugar rush moment, but they are still through to the third semi-final in four major tournaments under Gareth Southgate. Saturday's performance wasn't without its flaws, but England were galvanised by their shootout win over Switzerland.
Just looking at Seaman's role, that 10th position that he picks up, he got so much of the ball against Turkey, and turned and just his final ball, his final pass, just lacks a little bit of quality, but he certainly finds a space right enough in that 10. He's got 7 on his back, but he's just trying to hold that little space up. Gahey on that left-hand side, just got his eye on him.
Dispossessed by Osaka, and England are away. Kane trying to hold it up, gets it back to Saka. He's been allowed to play on. The advantage has sort of disappeared. Here is the German Felix there.
I just think that's a perfect opportunity for Trippier to get a bit of support on the right hand side. Whether it's because he's not an actual left sided player, up for debate. Well, it's not up for debate because he's not, but the fact of the matter is, of course, a perfect opportunity to release a left advancing player. Good play initially from Saka, though.
We're in a conversation with Gareth Southgate about his positioning on the field. He's just dropped back in to his right hand side.
In fact, he doesn't want to play on the left. Everything suits his game. People were saying, why isn't he playing on the left? To balance out England, he scores a goal from the right. That's why.
Simmons has dispossessed Rice, and he's got to the edge of the box, and he's flashed it past Jordan Pickford. Danny Simmons experiences a bit of Dutch delight, and England will hope that their latest setback is not an affirming one. It's one hell of an effort. And the Netherlands are in front.
Well, if you give the ball away in the last third, you're in trouble. Your back line has to drop off. And that's what they do. They drop off a little bit deep. Just give the ball away there, midfield, and then he's at you. The slip, the space. You've got to go to the ball at some point. Edge of the box. You have to engage the player. It's Rice who just gets dispossessed. Just talking about Seaman's not delivering, he delivered that, an absolute curler for the Dutch.
That's an unbelievable strike. Listen, he does everything himself. His initial tackle to win the ball from Declan Rice. He was really physical on Rice. Wins the challenge, goes forward 3 or 4 steps. I'll tell you what a strike in the football that is. Goalkeeper beaten by sheer pace.
Respond immediately. They've had to come from behind earlier in this tournament. Bellingham. This is Rice. On the back foot again.
I mean, Sam Lee, I take your point of again to close them down quicker. But what a bit of strike. Dear me, what a hit of the football that is.
Bring it on that far side. Bellingham just got a little
straight away when we lose the ball there. That's just a little head up the side of Bellingham. But I'm looking from a defensive point. I get it. It's been a mistake. Midfield, what's the back line doing? It has to drop to a certain extent because there's no pressure on the ball. You've got to get them set, but then you've got to go to the ball. It's got 5 yards to run into. You have to stick a leg up and get close. Great strike, man.
He was excellent against Romania. He came off the bench against the Austrians after just 35 minutes. Played most of the season on the left for Leipzig. Belongs ultimately to Paris Saint-Germain. And he has been linked with a number of clubs this summer, including Barcelona. He has scored the opening goal of the semi-final. Jude Bellingham just getting cleaned up by the England medical staff. Shouten is having the same treatment just a few yards away. And the Dutch have been vulnerable from set pieces. Harry Maguire's absence has been felt the keenest in this situation. No one has replaced the goal scoring threat of the highest scoring defender in England's history. But the Dutch have looked a little bit vulnerable from dead balls too, which is surprising bearing in mind the names in their defence.
Well, you look how experienced they are. Okay, 29, Van Dijk 32. Debris 32, Dumfries 28. Real line that stays together. They're very well organised, but as you said, this might be an Achilles heel. Let's hope so.
Yeah, it's worth mentioning as well. You know, you spoke about it before, Sam, the back four. Inter Milan, Liverpool, Man City. Bags of experience.
Nice game. Stones and Davey lining up. Ball was a good one. Headers just as well. Away Simons. Foden makes a dart in the channel. Gakpo from behind, it's going to be another England free kick.
I think it was a foul. I think he dallied just a little bit. He didn't really well coming in again. I think I'd say the Bukayo Saka. And he just wants to play into somebody's feet. I think Phil Foden runs in behind. Harry Kane stood up. It was a free kick though.
I mean, Saka's got such a language style about the way he runs. You know he's going to go on that left foot. You know he's going to cut inside. And it's so difficult because he lets the ball almost go between his legs and then he drags it with him. And for a defender, it just puts you on your heels a little bit.
Both Foden and Trippier standing over the ball. Trippier will whip this in. It's deep towards Declan Rice at the far post. And he almost came through to Harry Kane.
Oh, he's the head in it.
Oh, what a position. What a ball. Just sneaks in round the back. That's think the same. Can he just go and meet that with his head?
I think he's got to dive, really. I think he's got to dive and head it right across the face of the goal. Excellent cross, excellent delivery.
Just sort of underscores that issue that we were talking about with the Dutch defence from those dead ball situations.
Shows you, it doesn't matter how experienced you are, we don't pick people up in the box, you give chances away.
Absolutely. Marley, on home turf with Borussia Dortmund, dispossessed by Trippier. To net before in the Champions League this season. Bellingham. Now Kane dropping into a bit of space. Tried one from distance, which forces Arthur Buggan into his first save.
Just couldn't get out his feet. Reasonable strike. He does the right thing. He could have done with just another half yard out his feet.
That is first touch, Alan. Touch is just out his feet.
A bit. Just a little bit too close to him.
Yeah. Not enough time to take another touch.
No one has scored more goals in the knockout stages of this competition in its history than Harry Kane. He has been quiet by his high standards. Ali, what are your thoughts on what the reasons for that are? We heard in the studio the theories from Roy and from Gary and from Wrighty.
Do you know what I think, looking at him? He's had an exceptional season. I think it was 36 and 32. He just looks to his carrying a lot of an up.
Here's Kane. Space for Saka. Foden is in the centre. Saka takes on Ake. Tries to get it in on his left foot. He's still wandering. Might ricochet nicely for Kane.
Somehow it's over the top. The England players are asking for more than that.
He's got a whack as well. Yeah, it was a follow through. There was a defender just putting his foot up. But brilliant position for Bellingham. All set up from the number 10, getting the ball and turning, playing the ball forward. Eventually it falls to him, gets over it. I think it's Dumfries coming in from that right-hand side, just puts a foot up.
Yeah, it's just a clash, isn't it? To be quite honest with you, Harry could have done that. Could have done with that effort, the ball went maybe half a foot lower. He's got to get above it and keep it down, and he gets a block. There's his earlier shot. But certainly, he's taken a soul in there, but he's got to take it. I just think Saka's looked really, really lively again.
Just looking at that Bellingham, it's the first real time he's got it in that 10. Turned so quickly.
Well, let's just check in with Christina, Uncle. What are your thoughts on that? Any suggestion of a foul? I don't think so.
No suggestion by the VAR for recommendation on a penalty. Once Kane gets that shot off and it's clear, naturally they'll take a look to see whether or not Dumfries' action goes above and beyond. But it should be a check complete in terms.
Well, we just got a notification on our screens that they are going to go for a potential penalty check, and there is a nervous moment here. And now it's come up on the board in front of us as well. And he is coming over to have a look at this. So he has been advised to come over here and check to see if England are going to be given a penalty.
That
would be astonishing if this is given. Well, I think Christine is astonished as well. Christine, you're watching back in the Berlin studio.
Listen, the fact he's running over. Sorry, Christine, I'll be astonished if he doesn't give it.
I am. So one of the surprising things here is there a Studs contact? I just raised onto the top of the hoop. Kane, correct. However, Kane is getting this shot off completely. His momentum is following him through. I am quite surprised that this is being sent because it is not a clear and obvious error. And in fact, this preferred recommendation is for this to not be a penalty.
It is going to be a penalty for England. Forget the recommendation. England have a spot kick.
Well, I guess, I'm pleased, don't get me wrong. But
I think
from a defender's point of view, you've got a challenge for the ball there. They're both going for the ball. It's a split second. I don't think that's a penalty, but I really don't care.
I'll give you my toughest word right now. The fact of the matter is the defender's going to block the ball. And in truth, Harry Kane has kicked him because of his follow through, right? Because he's got to take the shot on. Not a penalty for me. I can understand why. As soon as you go over, the referee goes over. I certainly don't think for a minute it's a clear and obvious error.
Well, a yellow card has been issued to Denzel Dumfries as a result of it as well. Barbara Bruggen, 21-year-old Brighton goalkeeper, is being shuffled back to his goal line. And it's Harry Kane who's going to take the penalty for England. He wasn't on the pitch to take a penalty during the shootout against Switzerland. 76 penalties scored from 86 taken. He scored 21 for England. For the semi-final of the European Championships in front of the England fans requires a coolness and a composure that is very difficult to replicate. The England captain takes a huge gulp. So does the nation.
Come on.
It's for parity. It's Harry Kane. It's
yes! Good man.
England on the scoreboard. And in a sea of orange, it's a white shirt that is celebrating in the corner. England make their mark. Sometimes you do need a bit of a helping hand. And England are back in it. It's all square.
Well, absolutely. Sign of any injury there. Well, there's a twinge in his back, carrying something in his legs. A cool calculation of this. One big deep breath. You kind of guess where he's going to go. It's his favourite side. Solo, power, keeper, no chance.
Oh, it's a textbook penalty, isn't it? Over it, blowing hard, into the goal. Goalkeeper's bottom right hand corner. He can die for all he likes. But the placement and the power is excellent. I've got no doubt we'll be talking about the actual decision. Perhaps.